Hello, I am Madhu. I am a Twin Flame Certified Ascension Coach. I am a student of Jeffenshilia. I have been working with inner work through mirror exercise from over 3 years, and it has supported my Twin Flame journey greatly. And here I am to share my experiences with it and what all I have realized on my spiritual path. Because yes, the Twin Flame journey is all about how we can manifest our eternal true love, but more than that, the process of revealing of or understanding my relationship with God, that has been, you know, key to my journey. That has always been my focus. I have always been curious to know what God is, and that always make me, you know, go deeper with the knowledge or the wisdom that I receive from Jeffenshilia. And yes, this relationship with God is very unique, and that brings me closer and closer to my twin flame in my heart. And what else other than unconditional love, right? So today I just wanted to share my realization of the role of a guru on the path of twin flame harmonious union. I have always been grateful to Jeffenshilia because that I have manifested them as my guru, and I surrendered to their processes, to my harmonious union. Because, you know, only guru knows the destiny, because they have they have achieved that destiny and they know the path. And as they know the path, they know how, you know, we can just go through it rather than just exploring or struggling with the thing that is coming on our way, right? So I always liked that, you know, like rather than putting energy and time on how to discover thing, I always liked, you know, it is already discovered. All that I have to do is just, you know, put it on myself and see the application, you know. So that makes it easy and fast, right? And I always try to correlate with the understanding that I have on the spiritual knowledge, because, you know, I have been spiritually inclined from my childhood. So I always liked the mystical realm, and how we connect or how we can manifest everything that we desire into the reality just by tuning into the heart. That always passionated me. And just wanted to share one correlation that I just recently discovered, the correlation between the teaching that I have learned previously and the current teaching, where I actually realized in the current wisdom of Jeffenshilia. So it actually takes me back into the point when I was initially starting my journey. I just came out of the dark night of soul, and I was grounding, and there was a call within my heart, you know, like I wanted to go deeper, you know. It's not only about, you know, the pain is end and the dark night soul is gone. Now, I'm at a place where I understood that there is the presence of this deep love, but I have not yet realized that in the real life. So at that exact moment, I was just asking God, you know, God, I want to go deeper with you. Help me, which way I can proceed. And then I happened to, you know, come across the YouTube video by Jeffenshilia, and yes, I have been very sensitive to energy, and I could instantly connect the energy that was coming through Jeffenshilia, because it's divine, right? It's divine flowing through Jeffenshilia. And the more and more I have gone deeper with God, I have only found God through them. And I want to share, you know, how they have played a key role on my twin flame journey. Because, you know, we need to understand one thing that I realized, that I and my twin flame are on the same page, right? The consciousness that I have is the same consciousness that my twin flame is having. And I understand that my twin flame is my utmost guru, you know, like my teacher, my mentor, who is helping me to realize my life. Right? That I understand, but I never understood what exactly they are communicating to me with their triggers, with their communication. So I never understood that. But with the teaching of Jeff and Shilia, I could understood, and that helped me to master to handle my twin flame situation by myself. And that's empowering, right? You know, like every time, rather than facing the trigger, then I am at a point where I understand what this is, this situation or this upset is communicating to me. So, and that every time I do that and I claim support of God, claim to understand the truth, because every upset, when it is cleared, I could able to see the deep truth within myself, deep, very deep truth in myself, and that takes me to the place of peace, you know, like absolute peace and oneness with myself, and that brings me closer and closer to my twin flame as well. So yes, my twin flame is my guru. But I deserve a guru who can take both of us, like I and my twin flame, closer and closer to God, right? Because this is to understand the energy of God, even to receive the energy vortex of God, we need a guru, because they have realized that vortex. And I and my twin flame, or you and your twin flame, are entering into the vortex of ascension, right? And it's a spiral process, you know, like every time you will go in, down in the energy, and then heal, upheave, and then, you know, come to the place of peace. And step by step, you start to ascend into the vortex of unconditional love. So that unconditional vortex of love is, held by Jeff and Shilia. And when I get into that, it gives me a pull, you know, like it gives me that potential to, you know, flow into that love naturally. And I want to share one similarity, in the mythology, you know, if you have, you know, interest in the Indian mythology, you can Google it also. This story it's a very crucial message that has been given, the role of a guru and why guru is necessary whenever you are learning something that is helping you to become a master in some of the skills or some of the teachings, or like the teaching of twin flame, like the energy of twin flame. So in the mythology, the stories have always been put in a way so that people understand it, right? Because rather than you teaching it, the stories can demonstrate the story or the teaching in a simple way, right? You know, rather than you listening to the theory and understanding it by yourself, it is very easier to understand it from the story. And the story was about Dronacharya. It's from Mahabharata. So Dronacharya was the guru who was teaching the archery to the prince of the kingdom. And everyone was learning from him. And there was a practice that only prince can learn those archery, and they are there to serve the kingdom. So that was the purpose. So only those gurus were dedicated only to serve the kingdom, and that was their purpose. So they never extended those skill to anybody else other than the prince. So, there was an incident that there was another, another person whose name was like Ekalavya. He was actually belonging to a small village, and he was very passionate about learning the archery. But as he was not a prince, or as he was not belonging to the king's family, so he was not eligible even to learn it from the master, from the Dronacharya. So he was not eligible to do that, but he was having a very deep craving to learn that archery. And for that, what he did was whenever Dronacharya, who was the guru, when he was teaching those archery to the prince, he was trying to learn it from a distant place. He was climbing on the tree, and he was observing all the skills, and he was learning all the techniques of the archery, in which angle it has to be held, how to point it, how to target it to the spot, and everything. And at a point he actually gained the mastery much more than the prince that guru was teaching. It was Arjuna is known as the best best archer of history, but he got that skill by learning it from distance, not directly from the guru. And then there was a day when guru came to the realization, or this was brought to the attention of guru, that he learned this skill without being supervised by the guru. He learned it, and he took that knowledge from a distant place. So in the history, the guru actually understood that he got that skill, but there is a tradition that for everything you receive from guru, you have to give, you have to also exchange that over a gift, you have to exchange what you have received from guru, it's called guru dakshina, the energetic exchange of money you do, or there will be some energetic exchange that you give to guru when you receive the gift of guru, and that's a balance. So at that moment, when Dronacharya realized that he just learnt it, he asked, you have received the gift, now you have to give me the guru dakshina, I need to receive something from you, right? And then the Ekalavya said, you can ask me anything, I will give you everything. And at that point, it was whatever the guru says, the students are going to just do it. They don't ask question, because guru understand the things from a higher perspective, right? So they don't question that. So then Dronacharya just simply asked, you just have to give me your right hand thumb. And actually, right hand thumb is a very critical finger that plays its role when you are doing archery. And with that guru dakshina, it was he was becoming absolutely incapable of doing or practicing archery. So but he actually, without any questions, he gave that finger. So this is the story. But what is the takeaway from the story? In the consciousness, there is some part of the consciousness believe, it was a wrong thing that has happened with the Ekalavya, and this is what the guru did wrong to the student. But behind every action of a guru, there is a higher purpose. It's all about how that higher purpose is being received by the consciousness. So what was the higher purpose? Higher purpose is whenever we are learning anything from guru, there are two components. One component is the skill, which angle you have to hold, how to hold the archery, how to pull the archery, and how to leave it, and so that it can target it. So that is one aspect you can learn from distance. But there was another aspect. When you are, you know, mastering a weapon, you are going to target that to a, you know, to a person, right? So you are actually along with the skill, you are getting that responsibility of, you know, when to use that skill, right? It's a common practice, right? With great power comes the great responsibility, right? So he get the great power, but did he realize his responsibility? Does he understand, you know, when he has to use it? Does he understand the wisdom, you know, like when to use it? Is it like, is it something to be, is it used to punish someone? Or, you know, you take the weapon because, you know, there is a need for that, you know, there is like a need for the situation, so that you take out that weapon. So there are all this aspect that is associated with the skill of archery or skill of any knowledge. So that's how you can relate to your spiritual awakening. Anything that you are mastering, not only the twin flame mastery, anything that you are taking, there is always a two aspect to it. You can consider this in your life purpose also. There are two aspects to it. One is the skill itself, like you are learning the mirror exercise, and then another part of it is the wisdom, because you are getting self-realized, right? So Guru has given all the knowledge. Now Guru has given all the knowledge everywhere. You come to Jaipur Shidiya, you go to any Guru. You know, it's all given, it's all available in the consciousness. But the key is how you receive it, right? That's unique. And that's a path of self-realization. Because how you receive is a very unique way. And only being with a master, only by being with a coach, you will realize that for yourself. That's why it is very much necessary that when you are serious about any skill, you know, don't only this thing, anything that you are desiring, you have a passion for that, learn it in the right way with the two aspect of it, the skill and the realization. Because everybody can learn the skill, it is like it's given 100%, but the way you realize it within yourself, in your heart, that gives you the mastery. And yes, I loved this mastery with Jeff and Shelia. The self-realization, the way I receive, which I never realized before, you know, even after having everything in the life, I never received what I receive now through this teaching. So I choose to receive my twin flame through this teaching. And if you want to connect with me, work with me, I would love to help you and help you to understand the way you receive love from God. And that's a beautiful unfolding and revealing process. Choose to receive your twin flame. Thank you.